This is the letter which Chief Minister had written to me, and I will ask them to provide a copy. वो प्रिंस साहब आपके पास से हो थ्री लेटर्स ऑफ द चीफ मिनिस्टर एंड माय रिप्लाईज यू हैव दैट यस फर्स्ट लेटर और दिस इज द लास्ट लेटर नो दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेटर विच आई रोट ऑन December 8 कॉपी विल बी सप्लाईड टू यू वेयर इन आई सेड आई एम सिक ऑफ this pressure which is brought upon me and I don't want to continue as chancellor. If I had any vested interest, why I would say that I don't want to continue as chancellor? And I said in this letter that I know that the assembly is not, since this assembly is not in session, you can go for an ordinance, and I promise that I shall sign the same immediately. But you become chancellor. Relieve me of this duty. Why I was forced to write that letter? Chief Minister personally came to Raj Bhavan and requested me that in the matter of the appointment of Kannur University Vice Chancellor, that is his home district, and I agreed with him that I will give weightage to your opinion. You are democratically elected leader. Yes, I shall give weightage to your opinion. But we have to go through a process. That we did not discuss. We started the process for the selection of the vice chancellor. And my view was that since I have given word to the chief minister, I will, after the panel sends three names, selection committee, they send three names, then I will consult him and I will try to go by his choice. They possibly realize that the man of their choice may not find place in that panel. Therefore, Chief Minister, office people, they contacted me, they came here, and they said that since you have given word to Chief Minister that man of his choice will be appointed, therefore, why go through the process? I said, no, we should go through the process. Then his secretary, his legal consultant, he produced a document. This is the opinion of the Advocate General also, that direct appointment can be made. I ask you this question. If I have some legal problem, facing some legal problem, formally speaking, legally speaking, whom I should consult? AG of the state? Advocate General? Advocate General, without my asking, the opinion is already there. I have not asked for this opinion. The opinion he produced. I said, why I should believe that this is from AG? This is or has not been signed. Okay. Can we come in the evening again? I said, most welcome. They come in the evening and they produce not only the opinion of the AG, but also the request from the Education Minister, who happens to be Pro-Chancellor. Same thing. And saying that I am sending the opinion of Advocate General. Now, what was the course open for me? To enter into a legal battle because AG opinion is already there? And I'm not defending. I have already said that that was not right on my part to make that promise. I have already admitted to that mistake many times. But I had given word, it is true. I have not given word that I shall scuttle the process. They forced me with the letter of the Advocate General to scuttle the process. And Chief Minister in his defense said that under article so and so, Governor acted on the advice of the AG. AG immediately next day clarified the position that Raj Bhavan never sought my advice. Advice was given to the Education Ministry, who had sought my advice. Why Education Ministry sought his advice? To bring pressure on me. I realized that this pressure is going to continue. Therefore, I decided that I should not continue as chancellor. And I wrote the letter, which I have already told you, and they will provide the copies in which I said I am ready to sign even an ordinance. You become the chancellor. Now, this letter was replied on December 8 itself. I am not going into it. I did not accept, in which request was made to me to continue as chancellor. I did not accept it. I wrote on the same date, next day, December 9, saying that I do not accept the explanations which you have given and I stand by my decision. The reply came on 16 December, again requesting me that I will have to continue as chancellor. Then, even this I rejected. But I said, why continue this letter writing? I do not have that kind of relationship that I should enjoy reading these letters. So I said, now I'm not going to comment. If when I did not comment, then on, where is the last letter? Yes, it is here. The last letter. The last letter, all the ifs and buts, and to give you the complete story, a senior officer of the government came to Raj Bhavan with a draft and requesting me, asked me what I want to be written so that I can continue as chancellor. I made some modifications in that draft. And then this letter, same evening, came from Chief Minister. And the earlier letter also, he had said that government does not have any proposal to make any change in the, as far as the selection of the Vice Chancellor is concerned. He has written in his letter, you will read it. More interesting is something else which I will tell you about Professor C.N.R. Rao and Professor Panikkar. If I forget, please remind me. Now this, finally this letter came, which was on 13th January, in which all ifs and buts were dropped. I was requested to continue as chancellor. I was assured, now I'm quoting from the letter of the Chief Minister, I am of the considered opinion there should not be any intrusion into the academic autonomy of the universities from any quarter, leave alone government. He assured me that he will ensure there is no interference by the government or any other agency. I have not written this letter. He has signed it, this letter. And now what they are doing? They are not only changing the law, but saying in that law that there will be 5 members of the selection committee, 3 will be nominees of the government, and the decision will be taken by majority. Academic matters decision will be taken by majority. So, does he remember what he had written to me?